What the hell was that? What's going on here?
Surprise!
My birthday. It's my birthday. Do you know you had me scared to death? I was about to run out of this place like nobody's business. I was. I mean, what kind of friends would surprise you on your 35th birthday? Mine. Then again, how many times do you get to be 35? 11? Well, say it and get it over with. It's embarrassing. Come on, I can't stand it. Quick.
Happy birthday, Robert.
I stood it. Thank you for including me in your thoughts, your lives, your families. Yes. Thank you for remembering.
You don't look it.
Well, I feel it.
It's the birthday boy.
Oh, you've rehearsed. Very good. I'm touched.
Oh, I love it when people are really surprised.
She loves it when people are really surprised.
If you don't like it, you can take it back.
I haven't even seen it yet.
I mean, though, if you don't like it...
Why don't you wait until the man looks at the thing?
I'm sure I will like it.
Why don't you just take it back?
For God's sake, he just said he likes it.
Pretend not to notice, Harry, Robert. I think I'll leave.
I was being funny, Sarah.
We could stay a little longer.
Here, Bob, take ours back, too, why don't you?
Well, here's from Paul and me. If I were you, I would take it back and get the money. It cost so much, I fainted.
It did not, Robert. It's a sweater.
You told them what it was. Well, when I saw the price tag, I thought it was a house.
Miss, you! Yes, you. Tell them to take yours back and get the money. It's not the gift, it's the cost that counts.
Who is that?
That is I, miss. I am very rich, and I'm married to him, and I'd introduce him, but I forgot his name.
Many happy returns of the day, old man.
David is now going to deliver our greeting.
Oh. Go on, sweetheart.
Robert, happy birthday. From us.
And may this year bring you fame, fortune, and your first wife.
Listen, I am fine without the three.
You bet your ass, baby.
He might have meant that superciliously.
Oh, isn't she darling with all that free help?
All right, let's cut out the many happy returns. That is about enough about me. I am just indeed lucky to have all of you. I mean, when you've got friends like mine...
Happy birthday!
No, blow out the candles and make a wish. Don't tell your wish or it won't come true.
You have to close your eyes and blow them all out.
Be sure to make it a good one, Robert.
That...
still get your wish. He still gets his wish!
He does! Must be a new rule.
Sure you do. Don't believe a word of it.
But sure he does.
Oh, I know. I will. Actually, I didn't wish for anything.
He's kidding. You gotta be kidding.
Well, anyway, don't tell it.
Tell it if it's dirty.
They say you're not supposed to tell it.
Paul's right. Don't tell it.
Anyway, Robert, you're still in your prime. 35.
Harry, hush. You don't tell a person's age at our ages.
Bobby.
Bobby.
Bobby, baby.
Bobby, booby.
Bobby.
Robert, darling.
Bobby, we've been trying
Bobby.
To call
Bobby,
you.
Baby.
Bobby, booby.
Angel, I've got something Bobo. To tell
Bobby, love.
You.
Bobby, honey.
Bobby, we've
Angel,
been trying
Bobby,
to
meet you all day.
Bobby.
The kids were asking Bobby.
There was something
Bobby,
we wanted
Bobby,
to
Bobby.
Say.
Your mind was busy.
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby
sweetie,
how have you been?
Stop by
on your way home.
Seems
Bobby,
like weeks since we've
been
thinking
of you.
Drop by anytime.
Bobby, there's a concert on Tuesday.
Hank and Mary get into town.
All of us who scramble on Sunday.
Why don't we all go to the beach
Bobby,
next
happy
Saturday, Bobby?
Angel,
what you doing Thursday?
The time we got together is Wednesday, oh,
Bobby, darling.
Bobby, tell him.
Bobby, baby,
Bobby, come on over for dinner. We'll be so glad to see you. Bobby, come on over for dinner. Just be the three of us, only the three of us. We love you.
Phone rings, door chimes, in comes company. No strings, good times, room hums, company. Late nights, quick bites, party games, deep talks, long walks, telephone calls. Thoughts shared, souls bared, private names, all those photos up on the walls. With love, with love, filling the days. With love, 70 ways to Bobby with love. From all those good and crazy people, my friends. Those good and crazy people, my married friends. And that's what it's all about, isn't it? That's what it's really about. Really about.
Bobby.
Bobby.
Bobby, baby.
Bobby, booby.
Robbie.
Robert, darling.
Bobby.
Angel, will you do me a favor?
Name it Sarah.
Bob. Listen, pal, I need Bob. Your opinion.
Bobby, love.
Try me, Peter.
Bobby, there's a problem. Bobby. I need your advice.
Amy, can I call you back tomorrow?
You visit the kids once or twice.
What's happened to you, Bobby? Bobby, where have you been?
Stop by. On your way home.
Bobby, I've been thinking all
sorry,
Bobby.
Got a date with Jenny and Joe.
Bobby, dear, it's none of my business.
Look at pal, I have to work Thursday.
Bobby, you've been looking at you.
Bobby, boy, you know how I hate
Bobby,
it.
Bobby, come on over for dinner. We'll be so glad to see you. Bobby, come on over for dinner. Just be the three of us. Only the three of us. We Good and crazy people, my friends. Good and crazy people, my friends.
the door. I'll get it.
I'll get it.
No, I'll get it. I always do.
What was that clock chime?
5 o'clock.
Thank God. Cocktail hour.
Final boarding call for NSCW Flight 119. For those of you who have not boarded, please do so.
The hell is that noise?
Well, they're either clean in the building next door, tearing it down.
Taxi! Taxi!
Please!
Please! Will you stop throwing that board, you yo-yo!
Paul, what was that noise?
I don't hear anything.
Oh, David, the phone.
I'm getting it.
It'll wake the kids. It'll wake the kids.
There's cinnamon in the coffee, Robert. The odd taste is cinnamon. Sugar and cream?
Both. May I have lots of both?
Of course you may.
Oh, you want some brandy in it, Robert?
You having some?
Oh, we don't drink, but you go ahead, you darling.
Or you can have a real drink if you want. We have anything you want.
Oh, it's all right with you, then. Could I have some bourbon?
Right.
Sweetheart.
Okay, darling.
What? Are you both on the wagon? Sarah, you're not on the wagon.
Goodness, Robert, all the questions. Or do you just collect trivia like some old quiz show contestant? We spend half our lives with you, and now you notice Harry's on the wagon.
Year and a half.
No, love, just a year.
It's a year in February. It's a year and a half now.
I know for a fact next month it will be a year.
And a half.
1 year. Count it. One. Harry got arrested for being drunk and quit out of some kind of humiliation.
I quit to see if I could is actually what happened. Come on, I must have told you about all that.
Never. He never mentioned it or I never would have brought the bourbon. How were you arrested?
Another question. Here, why don't you have one of these brownies you brought?
I was in California on business, and I got really soused one night. And these guys drove me back to my hotel. But instead of going in, I walked down to the corner to get something to eat to sober up.
You said it was 3 blocks.
No, just the corner.
3 blocks.
Anyway, this cop car stopped me and said, "You're drunk." I said, "Drunk? I'm clobbered." He said, "I'm taking you in." I said, "Take me back to my hotel, for God's sake. It's just on the corner."
3 blocks away.
Anyway, they mugged me and they booked me for being drunk. Unbelievable. And then, Robert, it happens again the very next time I'm out there. Drunk driving. I only had wine.
Only 3 bottles.
And I insisted on taking a drunk test. I flunked it by 1 point.
And that is when you quit, Precious. He always thinks it was the first arrest, but it was the second. We never told you that? That's curious. I thought Harry had told everybody.
Anyway, I quit to see if I really have a drinking problem, and I don't.
Just a problem drinking.
Do you miss it?
No. No, I really don't.
Yes. Yes, he really does. Hi, darling.
Anyway. I stopped. Haven't had a drink since.
Whoops.
What's whoops? I haven't had a drink since.
At Sheila and George's wedding.
A toast, for God's sake. Oh, I'm sorry, Robert. You must have noticed how staggering, falling down drunk I got off of one swallow of champagne.
I never said you got drunk, but you did have the champagne.
A swallow. One swallow.
And it was gone. An elephant swallow.
I'd ask for another bourbon, but I'm terrified.
Robert, put a nipple on the bottle for all we care. Don't you want a brownie?
Oh, God, no, I'll bust.
Bust? You bust? Look at you. You skinny thing. Bones. You just skin and bones. I bet when you get on a scale, it goes the other way. Minus.
Thank you, Sarah. I'm flattered and touched, and I think I was just insulted.
Oh, Robert, I was praying you'd eat just one so I could watch.
Sarah, is it possible you've become a food voyeur?
Mexican food. What I crave without cease is Mexican food. With all the Tabasco sauce in the world.
Don't eat that brownie. I'm not. I was just smelling it. Oh, Robert, you eat one?
Not with the bourbon.
And chocolate. I'd kill for chocolate. Or a baked potato with sour cream and chives. Doesn't that just make you writhe? Oh, or sourdough bread, hot, with all the butter there is.
Chili.
Chili. Dear God, yes, chili.
Manicotti.
Manicotti. Just one teaspoon of manicotti.
Sarah Lee cake.
Sarah Lee is the most phenomenal woman since Eleanor Roosevelt.
I get the impression you guys are on diets.
Not me, Sarah.
Look at these pants. You can put your fist in them. That's how much weight I've lost.
She always does that. Look, I can put my fist down my pants too. She thinks I buy that.
Darling, I've lost 8 pounds already.
It's these magazines, Robert. You ever look at one of these women's magazines? It's just page after page of cakes and pies and roasts and potatoes. I bet Sarah subscribes to about 40 magazines. It's a sickness. We're up to our ass in magazines.
I read them all.
Don't.
Do.
Look at this, Robert. Wrestling. She even subscribes to a magazine about wrestling.
Karate. It's not wrestling. It's karate.
Wouldn't you love to see it? All those fat broads at her gym learning karate. What wouldn't you give to see that?
Strangely enough, darling, I'm terribly good at it.
How long you been studying?
Who asked that question? Oh, Robert! 7 months.
Show us some karate.
No. Robert, would you like some more coffee, love? You, Harry?
No, I want some karate. I want to see how my money is being hoisted.
No.
Do just one thing.
No!
Oh, come on, Sarah. I really would give anything to see you do just one thing. I bet you're excellent. Here, I'll be your partner.
Oh, Harry, this is just embarrassing.
Oh, come on.
My God. All right.
Hooray!
Okay. Harry, do you want to stand over there?
Okay. All right, I'm standing here. Now what?
Okay, now just come at me.
Okay.
Hey! To you, ma!
Fantastic. That's hysterical.
Actually, I could have prevented that.
How?
By blocking it.
No, that can't be blocked.
It certainly can. I just didn't do it.
Anyway, Robert, that can't be blocked.
Let's do it again. I'll come at you again.
Okay. Oh, I see. Okay, put me down. Let's do it again.
That's very good.
Once more.
Harry, could I have another bourbon?
give up.
Do you?
I've got you.
I've got you.
You want to do it again?
Okay, you break first.
You break first.
We could just stay here.
All right with me. Fine with me.
You're both very good.
Thank you. I could get out of this, you know.
Try it.
Okay, I tried it.
Uncle
your ass!
It's the little things you share together, swear together, wear together, that make perfect relationships. The concerts you enjoy together, neighbors you annoy together, children you destroy together, that keep marriage intact. It's not so hard to be married when two maneuver as one. It's not so hard to be married, and Jesus Christ, is it fun? It's sharing little wings together, drinks together, kings together, that make marriage a joy. It's bargains that you shop together, cigarettes you stop together, clothing that you swap together, that make perfect relationships.
Harry, could I have another bourbon?
No, wait. I'm kind of right in the middle of it.
It's not talk of God and the decade ahead that allows you to get through the worst. It's I, you, and you don't, and nobody said that. And who brought the subject up first? It's the little things. The little things.
The little ways you try together.
Cry together.
Lie together.
That make perfect relationships. Becoming a cliche together.
Growing old and gray together.
Withering away together.
That make marriage a joy.
It's not so hard to be married.
It's much the cleanest of crimes.
It's not so hard to be married.
I've done it 3 or 4 times.
It's people that you hate together.
Mate together.
Date together. That make marriage a joy.
It's things like using force together.
Shouting till you're hoarse together.
Getting a divorce together.
That make perfect relationships.
Kiss. Why? Wow. How about that?
I had you there.
I had you there. No.
I'd say it was a draw. Wow. Look at the time. I really gotta go.
Oh.
Wow. Listen, I had a great time.
So did we.
So great to see you. Are you sure you don't want to stay for a nightcap?
Right. Well, I see you guys soon.
Don't answer that, Harry. He gets no more questions, that sneaky Pete.
Wow. Thanks again.
I'll turn out the lights.
No, I will. I always do.
No, you don't.
Oh, Harry. I love you.
Harry. You ever sorry you got married?
You're always sorry. You're always grateful. You're always wondering what might have been. Then she walks in. And still you're sorry, and still you're grateful, and still you wonder, and still you doubt.
and she goes out. Everything's different, nothing's changed, only maybe slightly rearranged. You're sorry, grateful, regretful, happy. Why look for answers where none occur? You always are what you always were, which has nothing to do with, all to do with her.
Harry, darling, come to bed.
Coming, darling.
You're always sorry. You're always grateful. You hold her thinking, I'm not alone. You're still alone. You don't live for her, you do live with her. You're scared she's starting to drift away, and scared she'll stay.
Good things get better, bad get worse. Wait, I think I meant that in reverse.
You're sorry, grateful, regretful, happy. Why look for answers where none occur? You'll always be what you always were, which has nothing to do with, all to do with her.
You'll always be what you always were, which has nothing to do with, all to do with her. Nothing to do with, all to do with her.
I'm out here.
What the hell are you doing out here?
Wow, it is great to have a terrace in this city.
Wow!
Really? We just use it to store old sleds and stuff.
Hundreds of thousands of terraces in New York. Never have I seen a single person standing out on even one of them.
Plus, you worry about kids tracking in dirt or falling over.
And everybody can hear everything you say. You listening? Not to mention all the bird poop.
And noisy. I mean, you cannot even hear yourself think. And what can you see? All you can see is the building across the street.
If you lean way out over here and look over there, you can see the East River.
Except we decided that you can't. Peter almost met his maker one night trying to see that dumb old East River. He did.
You saved him?
Me? No. Well, I suppose, in a way.
She fainted, so I got down.
Peter just is not afraid of anything at all. Unfortunately, I simply was not made that way. One day, Peter fell off the ladder when he was putting up my curio cabinet, and he split his head open. Well, I fainted. I came to, I looked at his head, and I fainted again.
Four times she fainted that day.
Well, see, now, to me, that is so sweet. That is charm. Oh, you gotta be one lucky guy, Peter. I mean, that kind of southern graciousness, there just ain't much of that around these parts. You two are, he said, with envy, just beautiful together. Really, a terrific pair. And Peter, if you ever decide to leave her, I wanna be the first to know.
Well,
you're the first to know.
We are getting a divorce.
We haven't told anybody yet.
Oh. I'm so surprised. Maybe you'll work it out. Don't think so, huh? Well, I'm sure nobody can imagine how you feel. Or you feel. Or I feel.
Feel? I don't feel anything. Here, David, I don't care for anymore. That's too small. It's too small. It probably just doesn't work on me. Do you feel anything, David? Because I don't. Do you, honey?
You will.
When? I mean, we've had two, for heaven's sake. I mean, I think it probably depends on a person's constitution, right, Dave? Well, listen, it's always good to try everything once.
Just wait.
I'm not planning on going anywhere. Maybe I'm just too dumb or square, but honestly, I don't feel a thing. Honestly, I don't. Do you, Dave? Because I don't. Honestly, not a thing. Absolutely nothing. I mean, I wish that I did. I just don't. Maybe they gave you real grass right off the front lawn. I knew I wouldn't feel anything. I mean, I just don't have that kind of constitution. Why am I talking so much?
You're stoned.
Am I? Am I? I am not.
I am.
Are you, Dave? You are not. I'm so dry.
You're stoned.
Is that part of it?
You'll probably get hungry, too.
Am I supposed to feel that, too?
You don't have to feel anything.
Are you hungry, Dave?
No, I'd like some water, though.
Me too. Robert, do you want some?
No, thank you.
What?
I already have some, Jenny. Thank you.
Some what, Robert?
You asked him, honey. Water?
I completely forgot what we were talking about.
So you forget when you're high.
Wow! Are you high, Dave?
I'm potted.
Potted! That's beautiful! Jesus.
Wow, you're really high now, huh?
Jesus.
That's twice you said Jesus.
You're kidding.
No, that you said it two times. She never swears.
I remember saying it once.
Say son of a bitch.
Son of a bitch.
Say kiss my ass.
Kiss my ass. Kiss my ass, you son of a bitch. Oh, Jesus. Oh, that's three. Let's lavish to ourselves.
Oh, Jenny, you're terrific. You're the girl I should have married.
Oh, listen. Listen. There's a darling girl in our building who I think you're gonna love.
What?
When are you gonna get married?
What?
I mean it. I don't think a person is complete until he's married.
No, he's complete enough. You're better off the way you are.
That's what I hear.
You mean that, Dave?
Well, frankly, sometimes I'd like to be single.
That's not even funny.
It has nothing to do with you.
I'm your wife.
And that's the way I want it. But didn't you ever wish that you could be single again? I mean, for an hour even.
No. Could you make it 2 hours? Oh, Bobby, you better get married. You see the ideas you're giving Dave?
Oh, I will. It's not like I'm resisting marriage. It's resisting me, if anything. I'm ready.
Actually, you're not. But look, maybe not everybody should be married, I guess.
I don't know. Actually, a man should be married. Your life has a what? What am I trying to say? a point to it. A bottom. Know what I'm saying? I mean, I have everything but freedom. Which is everything. Huh. No, this is everything. I have my wife, my kids, a home, you know? I just feel that you have to give up to get. You know what I'm saying?
Listen, I agree. But the thing that bothers me is if you marry, then there's another person there all the time. Plus, you can't get out of it, even if you just might want to get out of it. You're caught, see? And then even if you do get out of it, what do you have to show for it? Not to mention the fact that then you've always been married. You can never not have been married again.
I don't think you're really ready. Do you think that, I mean subconsciously, that you are trying to resist it?
No. Negative. Absolutely not. There is no block, no resistance. I am ready to be married.
Then why aren't you?
I've had things I wanted to accomplish. That's the main reason. I mean, first I had to finish school, then I wanted to get, you know, started, get some kind of security, and just, you know, things I wanted to do before I could even begin to think in terms of marriage. And I know that sounds like rationalization, but it's not. It's not. Frankly, I just wanted to have some fun before I settle down.
Right, and you've done all those things.
Right, then why am I not married, huh? Wow. Taking me on a bummer. Wait, though. You just wait. You're gonna see some major changes in my life. I meet girls all the time, all over the place. You just have to live in New York. You meet a girl a minute. And I have met some real special ladies recently. Right now, I am dating this flight attendant. She's cute, original, odd. And then there's Kathy. You guys never met Kathy, did you? Oh, she's the best. I'm talking the best. And then there's Marta. God, she is fun. I am certainly not resisting marriage.
Really? That's not really? What you
no.
said before.
I don't remember that.
I'm ready to be married.
Right. So why aren't you?
Right.
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 You could drive a person crazy. You could drive a person mad. First you make a person hazy. So a person could be happy. Then you leave a person dangling, sadly, outside your door, which it only makes a person gladly want you even more. I could understand a person if he said to go away. I could understand a person if he actually was gay. But worse than that, a person that titillates a person and leaves her flat. He's crazy, he's a troubled person. He's a truly crazy person himself.
You son of a bitch.
I think you're crummy.
Up yours, turkey. When a person's personality is personable, he shouldn't ought to sit like a lump. It's harder than a matador coercing a bull to try to get you off of your rump. So single and attentive and attractive a man is everything a person could wish. But turning off the person is the act of a man who likes to pull the hooks out of fish.
Knock, knock, is anybody there? Knock, knock, it really isn't fair. Knock, knock, I'm working on my charm. Knock, knock, a zombie's in my arms. All that sweet affection, what is wrong? Where's the loose connection? How long, oh Lord, how long? Bobby, baby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby. You could drive a person buggy. You could blow a person cool. First you make a person feel all huggy, while you make her feel a fool. When a person says that you have sad her, that's when you're good. You impersonate a person. if he wasn't good in bed. I could understand a person if he actually was dead. Exclusive you, elusive you. Will any person ever get the chance of you? You're crazy. You're a lovely person. You're a moving, deeply maladjusted, never to be trusted.
I'm gonna go get us some food. Do any of you sons of bitches wanna help? Then kiss my ass.
Oh boy.
Did you light another one?
Oh no, it's just a cigarette.
Do you want another?
Maybe one?
No.
I can roll another one in a second.
No.
No more?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
It'll just take me a second to roll another one.
Listen, you two have one.
I don't want one.
Have one if you want one.
But I don't. I'm gonna go get some food. Isn't he a marvelous man?
I married a square. A confessed square.
Bobby! Bobby, you put that stuff away, huh? Come on, come on, put it in your pocket. Thank you. Maybe you're right. Whoever knows.
What was all that?
Ah, she doesn't go for it. I knew she wouldn't go for it.
She was stoned.
Oh, not really. She doesn't get things like that. I mean, you know, she'll go along with it, but that's about it.
She didn't like it?
I know her. She didn't.
You want me to get you some?
Well, she'd have a fit. I'm really surprised she did it tonight.
She loved it.
For me. She loved it for me. She didn't really love it. She's what she said. Square. Dumb.
Like a fox.
I'll go see if I can give her a hand. What do you say?
Wow. Oh, wow.
Bobby.
Bobby.
Bobby, baby.
Bobby, booby.
Bobby, Bobby, darling. Bobby, we've been trying
Bobby.
To reach
Bobby,
you.
Bobby, baby.
Bobby,
booby.
Angel, I've got
Bravo.
Something to tell
Bobby,
you.
Bobby, honey.
Bobby,
Bobby, it's important.
Bobby,
for
Bobby, baby. Bobby, Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby, Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby,
Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby,
Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby,
Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, wait till you meet her. Have I got a girl for you, boy? Who, boy? Dumb and with a weakness for sass or excellence. You give her even the fruit and she swings. The kind of girl you can't send through the mails. Call me tomorrow, I want the details. I got a chick for you. Wait till you meet her. Have I got a chick for you, boy? Who, boy? Smart! And all these exotic mystiques, the Kama Sutra and Chinese techniques. I hear she knows more than 75. Call me tomorrow if you're still alive. Have I got a girl for you?
I got a girl for you.
Wait till you meet her.
Wait till you meet her.
I got a girl for you.
I got a girl for you.
Boy,
boy, boy, to be in your shoes, what I wouldn't give. I mean the freedom to go out and live. As for settling down and all that. Be where it's been, but it's not where it's at.
Oh, listen.
What do you like? You like coming home to a kiss? Somebody with a smile at the door.
What do you like? You like indescribable bliss. Then what do you want to get married for? What do you like? You like an excursion to Rome, suddenly taking off to explore. What do you like? You like having meals cooked at home. Then what do you want to get married for? What do you want to get married for? What do you want to get married for? What do you want to get married for?
Someone is waiting, cool as Sarah, easy and loving as Susan. Jenny, someone is waiting, warm as Susan, frantic and touching as Amy. Joanne, would I know her even if I met her? Have I missed her? Did I let her go? A Susan sort of Sarah, a Jenny-ish Joanne. Wait for me, I'm ready now. I'll find you if I can. Someone will hold me, soft as Jenny, skinny and blue-eyed as Amy. Susan, someone will wake me, sweet as Amy, tender and foolish as Sarah. Joanne, did I know her? Have I waited too long? Maybe so, but maybe so has she. My blue-eyed Sarah, warm Joanne, sweet Jenny, loving Susan, crazy Amy. Wait for me, I'll hurry. Wait for me, hurry, wait for me, hurry, wait.
Another 100 people just got off of the bus and are looking around at another 100 people who got off of the plane and are looking at us who got off of the train and the plane and the bus maybe yesterday. It's a city of strangers, some come to work, some to play. A city of strangers, some come to stare, some to stay. And every day, the ones who stay can find each other in the crowded in the guarded parks, by the rusty fountains and the dusty trees with the battered box. And they walk together past the postered walls with the crude remarks. And they meet at parties through the friends of friends who they never know. Will you pick me up or do I meet you there? Shall we let it go? Did you get my message? Cause I looked in vain. Can we see each other Tuesday if it doesn't rain? Look, I'll call you in the morning, all my service will explain. And another 100 people just got off of the train.
Oh, I didn't come right to New York. I went to Northwestern University for 2 years. It was a pitiful mistake. I was on probation the whole 2 years. And I was getting ready to go back to Shaker Heights when I decided where I really wanted to live more than any place was Radio City. I thought it was this wonderful little city next to New York, so I came. I'm very dumb.
You're not dumb, April.
To me, I am. I mean, even the reason I stayed in New York is because I just cannot get interested in myself. Oh, I'm so boring.
I find you very interesting.
Well, I'm just not. I used to think I was so odd, but my roommate's the exact same way. He's also very dumb.
Oh, you'd never mentioned him. Is he your lover?
Oh, no. We just share his great big apartment on West End Avenue. We have our own rooms and everything. I'd show it to you, but we've never had company. He's very sweet, actually. I think he likes the arrangement. I don't know, though. We've never discussed it. He was born in New York, so nothing really interests him. I don't have anything more to say.
And they find each other in the crowded streets and the guarded parks, by the rusty fountains and the dusty trees with the battered box. And they walk together past the posted walls with the crude remarks. And they meet at parties to the friends of friends who they never know. Will you pick me up or do I meet you there? Shall we let it go? My message, cause I looked in vain. Can we see each other Tuesday if it doesn't rain? Look, I'll call you in the morning on my service will explain. And another 100 people just got off of the train.
This is really exciting, Kathy. Fascinating.
Robert, you're awful.
You come here a lot, huh? Terrific. Maybe next we can go watch a haircut.
Oh, you can't bear that with a big party going on. I talked you into coming here with me.
Party? What party? Oh, that party. I had completely forgotten about that party. Hey, maybe we can still make it.
Oh, Robert. Will you try to enjoy this?
There's a...
Imagine being in a tiny, quiet pocket of a park. Right here in the middle of the busy, noisy East 50s. A park that's simple and pretty. With that waterfall on the wall that always makes me ache to be back at the Cape.
You are some piece of work, lady.
What I am is like this park here. Out of place.
You are like this park. Very lovely. Very.
I used to dream I'd come to New York, have two terrific affairs, and then get married. I always knew I was meant to be a wife.
How come we never got married? Why'd you never ask me?
You want to marry me?
I did. Honestly, I did. In the beginning. But I don't know. I didn't think you would.
Oh. I would. I've never understood why you've never asked me.
So you wanted to marry me, and I wanted to marry you. Then how the hell did we ever become such good friends?
Robert.
Hmm?
I never let you know what a good, good man I think you are. And how much you've meant. Robert. I brought you here because I wanted to tell you alone. I'm moving back up to Cape Cod. I'm getting married.
Married?
Some people still get married, you know.
What, did you just suddenly fall in love?
I'll be a good wife. I want real things now. a husband, a family. I don't want to keep running around the city pretending like I'm having a life.
The problem is you want too little. And that's the hardest thing in the world to get. Thank you for your park.
You're welcome. But see, it and I, we just don't fit. I think there's a time to come to New York and a time to leave. Enjoy your party.
Another 100 people just got off of the train and came up through the ground, while another 100 people just got off of the bus and are looking around at another 100 people who got off of the plane and are looking at us who got off of the train and the plane and the bus maybe yesterday. It's a city of strangers. Some come to work, some to play. A city of strangers. Some come to stare, some to stay. And every day, some go on. Or they find each other in the crowded streets and the guarded parks, by the rusty fountains and the dusty trees with the battered backs. And they walk together past the postered walls with the crude remarks. And they meet at parties with the friends of friends who they never know. Will you pick me up or do I meet you there? Shall we let it go? Did you get my people just got off of the train, and another 100 people just got off of the train, and another 100 people just got off of the train, and another 100 people just got off of the train, another 100 people just got off of the train.
Want to know why I came to New York? I came because New York is the center of the world, and that's where I want to be. You know what the pulse of this city is?
Busy signal?
The pulse of this city, kiddo, is me. This city is for the me's of this world. People that want to be right in the heart of it. I am like the soul of New York.
Well, how about that?
See, smart remarks do not a person make. How many Puerto Ricans do you know?
Frankly, only seem to meet people like myself.
God, that's pathetic. Jews, Hispanics, gays, Arab street people, all my closest and my best friends. Listen, I don't pass people on the street. I stop and I know them. In this city, every son of a bitch I meet is my new best friend. Oh, I go uptown, like to the dentist or something, and I swear, suddenly, I want to cry because I think, oh my God, I'm uptown. Oh, and 14th Street. Well, I don't know why anybody talks about any place else, because that is the center of the universe.
14th Street?
That's humanity. 14th Street, that's everything. And if you don't like it there, they've got every subway you can name to take you where you like it better.
God bless 14th Street.
This city! I kiss the ground of it! Someday. You know what I want to do? I want to get all dressed up in black. Black dress, black shoes, hat, everything black. And go and sit in some bar at the end of the counter and drink and cry.
That is my idea of honest to God sophistication. I mean, that's New York. You always make me feel like I got the next line. What is it with you?
I just never met anybody like you.
Me neither. You know what this city is? Where a person can feel it? Hmm. It's in a person's ass. If you're really a part of this city, I mean, relaxed and cool, in the whole flow of it, your ass is like this. If you're just living here, walking around, uptight, not really part of this city, your ass is like this.
I hesitate to ask. It's a fascinating theory. Fascinating. And at this moment, extraordinarily accurate.
I can't find my shoes anywhere. Today's for Amy. Amy, I give you the rest of my life to cherish and to keep you, to honor you forever. Today's for Amy, my happily soon to be wife.
Amy, we'll really get married.
Pardon me, is everybody there? Because if everybody's there, I want to thank you all for coming to the wedding. I'd appreciate your going even more. I mean, you must have lots of better things to do, and not a word of it to Paul. Remember, Paul, you know the man I'm going to marry, but I'm not, because I wouldn't ruin anyone as wonderful as he is. But I thank you all for the gifts and the flowers. Thank you all. Now it's back to the showers. Don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today.
Paul can't find his good cufflinks.
On the dresser, right next to my suicide note. Listen, everybody, look, I don't know what you're waiting for. A wedding, what's a wedding? It's a prehistoric ritual where everybody promises fidelity forever, which is maybe the most horrifying word I've ever heard, and which is followed by a honeymoon where suddenly you realize you saddled with a nun and want to kill me, which you should. So listen, thanks a bunch, but I'm not getting married. Go have lunch, because I'm not getting married. You've been grand, but I'm not getting married. Don't just stand there. I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today. So can't you go? Why is nobody listening? Goodbye, go and cry at another person's wake. If you're quick for a kick, you could pick up a christening. But please, on my knees, there's a human life at stake. Listen, everybody, I'm afraid you didn't hear, or do you want to see a crazy lady fall apart in front of you? Is it only Paul who may be ruining his life? You know what, both of us be losing our identities. I telephoned my analyst about it, and he said to see him Monday, but by Monday I'll be floating in the Hudson with the other garbage. I'm not well. You've been swell, but I'm not getting married. Clear the hall, because I'm not getting married. Thank you all, but I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today.
die like Eliza on the ice. But perhaps I'll collapse in the apps right before you all. So take back the cake, burn the shoes, and boil the rice.
Miss Bell, I didn't want to have to tell you, but I may be coming down with hepatitis, and I think I'm going to faint. So if you want to see me faint, I'll do it happily. But wouldn't it be funnier to go and watch a funeral? So thank you for the 27 dinner plates, the 37 butter knives, the 47 paperweights, the 57 candles.
One more thing.
I'm not getting married.
I thought you said.
Still, I'm not getting married.
With this ring.
But I'm not getting married.
I be wed.
I'm not getting married. That does pray, but I'm not getting married.
Amy?
You're starting. Don't talk, please. Why don't the two of you sit down and talk to each other? I can't think with the two of you following me every place I go, from the bedroom to the bathroom to the kitchen. I feel like I'm leading a parade. Paul, stop staring. I feel it like bullets right through my back. No, Paul, please. I am so crazy. I left the refrigerator door open last night, so the orange juice is hot. Here. And if you say thank you, I will go running right out of this apartment and move into the hopeless cases section at Bellevue, where they will understand me. Don't talk, please. Oh, Paul, I apologize. Oh, Paul, you say whatever you want to say, whatever you like. Who am I telling you what to do? Oh, Paul.
The orange juice is hot, but thanks.
See, Paul, you don't thank a person for hot orange juice, you slug 'em! The toast! No, I blew the toast!
That's okay.
I can't stand it! It's not okay, Paul. Nothing about it remotely resembles okay. It is the opposite of okay. See, Robert, this is the real me, crazed.
I was just thinking that this is a much more interesting wedding breakfast than most. The bride is in a high-energy mode. The groom is abnormally quiet. And yet, a festive atmosphere pervades the room. I guess it's the best man smiling, even as he dies from drinking boiled orange juice.
I would laugh, Robert, if it all weren't so tragic. How do I look? Funny?
Yeah, it's a funny dress.
That dumb hairdresser curled my hair like he was on withdrawal. Paul, what are you so happy about all the time?
You.
This is the most neurotic, insane. It is so crazy having this enormous wedding and everything after we've been living together all these years. It's embarrassing, Paul. People will think I'm pregnant.
That's next year. Listen, if we hurry, we're late.
What am I doing? I'm 31.
And perfect.
Oh, an oldie but a goodie, huh? It's just incredible. 2 years with a psychiatrist and look where it leads. I'm just so glad we're not having a Catholic wedding, because next year when I get the divorce, I won't be a sinner. Whoever would have thought I would marry someone Jewish? Jewish! I mean, I didn't even know anybody who was Jewish. See, Robert, that was probably my main attraction. Look what a little Catholic rebellion will lead to. The very first moment I met Paul, I said to myself, that's what I really want, that Jew. Oh, he was so beautiful, inside and out, beautiful. Paul would kiss me and I would think to myself, oh, I got my very own Jew.
What is all this about me being Jewish today? About 3/4 of your friends are Jewish. Come on, hurry.
Did I ever say I like my friends? I do not. I much prefer my Gentile enemies. At least they leave you alone. And I need to be left alone. I am just like Robert.
Well, I'm not like that. What the hell are you talking about?
But don't answer, because we don't have time.
Amy, after all these years, don't you know we fit?
The higher you go, the harder you hurt when you fall.
I never dropped you yet.
Whoever reads this, I love you. Well, thank you. I love you, too.
Thank him, the Phantom. He leaves notes like that all over the place. A person can't stand all that sweetness, Paul. Nobody human can stand all that everlasting affection.
Amy, don't you think we should go?
I can't.
Amy, if anybody should be married, it's you. Tell her, Robert.
Robert, tell me. Who's gonna tell Robert?
Paul, I can't tell anybody anything like that. I mean, whatever is right will happen, I guess.
I see.
Look, I'm gonna call. I'm gonna call and say we're gonna be late. A little bit late. The people should be arriving now, don't you think?
Amy, don't you see what you're doing to yourself? You know, if other people did to you what you do to yourself, they could be put in jail. Come on.
Oh, look, Paul. Look, it's starting to rain.
It's starting to rain. The line was busy. Oh, guess who I ran into on my way over here? Helen Kincaid. Remember Helen Kincaid? I brought her around a couple times. Anyway, she's married now. I almost didn't recognize her. She was all fat and blousy and...
Amy, come on, we're late.
I just can't do it, Paul. I don't understand how I ever let it get this far.
Amy, come on, all of our friends are waiting.
That's no reason, Paul. I just can't. I'm so afraid.
Of what?
I don't know. I just think maybe you're really not for me, Paul. I just think maybe nobody's really for me. I never saw one good marriage, never, not in my entire life.
You see what you look for, you know? I've seen lots. Listen to me, Amy. Married people are no more marriage than musicians or music. Just because some of the people are wrong, it doesn't matter. It is still right.
Yes, well, I'll put that on a sampler, Paul. I'm not being emotional. I'm as sane as can be. Paul, I'm sorry I don't love you enough.
Robert, would you call and explain? And,
what did I just do?
You did what you had to do, I guess. I mean, if it wasn't right, then you shouldn't go through with it. That's what I think, at least. Amy. Marry me.
What?
Marry me.
Huh?
You said it before. We're just alike. Why don't we, Amy?
Why don't we, Robert?
Bobby! Bobby! Bobby, baby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby.
Marry me, and everyone will leave us alone.
Bobby, Bobby, how have you been? Stop by on your way home. Bobby, we've been thinking of you.
It's some world, isn't it? I'm afraid to get married, and you're afraid not to. Thank you, Robert. I'm really... It's just... You have to want to marry somebody. Not just somebody. Oh, will you look at that? He went out without his umbrella or anything. He'll get pneumonia. I've got to catch him. I'm getting married. Oh, and he's so good, isn't he? He's so good.
Amy.
I'm the next bride.
Marry me a little, love me just enough, cry but not too often, play but not too rough, keep a tender distance so we'll both be free. That's the way it ought to be. I'm ready, marry me a little, do it with a will, make a few demands I'm able to fulfill. Want me more than others, not exclusively, that's the way it ought to be. I'm ready. I'm ready now. You can be my best friend. I can be your right arm. We'll go through a fight or two. No harm, no harm. We'll look not too deep, we'll go not too far, we won't have to give up a thing, we'll stay who we are. Right, okay then, I'm ready. Marry me a little, love me just enough, warm and sweet and easy, just the simple stuff. Keep a tender distance so we'll both be free. That's the way it ought to be. I'm ready, marry me a little, body, heart and soul, passionate as hell but always in control. Want me first and foremost, keep me company, that's the way it ought to be. I'm ready. I'm ready now. Oh, how gently we'll talk. Oh, how softly we'll tread all the stings, the ugly things we'll keep unsaid. We'll build a cocoon of love and respect. You promise whatever you like, I'll never collect. Right. Okay then. I'm ready. I'm ready now. Someone. I'm ready. I'm ready.
Thank you. blessings, Robert.
Don't tell your wish or it won't come true.
Oh.
Okay.
You just blew it.
Well, it probably was a wish you wouldn't have got anyway, Robert.
You wish for a wife, Robert?
Don't, you lucky son of a gun. You hang in there.
Stay just as you are. You may be the one constant in this world of variables.
I don't know, Sarah. You can't stay in your 30s forever.
You still get your wish.
Won't.
I think he still gets his wish.
I say he won't.
Joanne, come on. Whenever she and Robert get together...
Larry, I'm telling you, if you do not blow out all the candles on the cake, you do not get your wish. I know all the rules for birthday candle blowing out. I've had enough for a wax museum.
All right, all right. Actually, I didn't wish for anything.
What do you mean you didn't wish for anything?
Oh, tell. Everybody is so curious.
Tell, but lie. Thank you for including me in your lives, your thoughts. I mean... when you've got friends like mine. When you've got friends like mine. Isn't it warm? Isn't it rosy? Side by side.
He's such a cutie.
By side.
Isn't he a cutie?
Ports in a storm. Comfy and cozy. Side by side.
He never loses his cool.
By side.
I envy that.
Everything shines. How sweet. Side by side.
We're just so fond of him.
By side. Parallel lines. Who meet.
Love him. Can't get enough of him.
Everyone winks. Nobody's nosy. Side by side.
He's just crazy about
by
me.
Side.
He's a very tender guy.
You make the drinks and I'll bring the posy. Side by side.
He's always there when you need
by
him.
Side. One is lonely and two is boring. Think what you can keep ignoring. Side.
He's my best friend.
By side.
Second best.
By side.
Never bother. Seven times a godfather. Year after year. Older and older.
It's amazing. We've gotten older each year, and he seems to stay exactly the same.
Sharing a tear. Lending a shoulder.
You know what comes to my mind every time I see him? The Seagram's building. Isn't that funny?
Hey, we got fun. No train.
Sometimes I catch him looking and looking, and I just look right back.
Permanent sun, no rain. We're so crazy, he's so sane. Friendship forbids anything better.
A person like Bob, he doesn't have the good things, and he doesn't have the bad things, but he doesn't have the good things.
Being a kiss as well as a sitter.
Let me make him a drink. He's the only guy I know I feel should drink more.
One's impossible, two is dreary, three is company, safe and cheery.
Side by side.
By here side. Is the church, here is the steeple. Open the door. And see all the crazy married people.
What would we do without you? How would we ever get through? Who would I complain to for hours? Who bring all the flowers when I have the flu? Who finished yesterday's soup? Who take the kids to the zoo? Who was so dear? And who was so deep? And who would keep her occupied when I'm on asleep? How would we ever get through? What would we do without you? What would we do without you? How would we ever get through? Should there be a marital squabble, available bobble, be there with the glue? Who could we open up to? Who? Secrets we keep from guests. Who? Who? Who is so safe? And who is so sound? You never need an analyst to Bobby around. How would we ever get through? What would we do without you? Wishes, who helps with the dishes and never says boo? Who changes subjects on cue? Who cheers us up when we're blue? Who is a flirt but never a threat? Remind us of our purpose, which we always forget. How will we ever get through? What will we do without you?
Usually do.
Right! You will sit with us, you will share with us, you will sit with us, you will bear with us, you will.
Thank you.
Just darling. Did you do it yourself?
Me?
Yes. I did, yes.
Yourself?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Well, it's just darling. Did you really do it yourself?
Yes. Why? Did you hear I didn't?
No. Oh, but look at this. This is just precious.
Huh, it is, isn't it? Look at that. I've never really looked at it. I just live here.
Well, it's terribly clever. I mean, look how nicely all the furniture's placed in little areas. To make it so warm and sweet and tucked in.
How about that?
And the colors, they're so simple and relaxing and masculine.
See that?
Well, isn't that tasteful and interesting?
Yes, I'll take it! I mean, I like my apartment, but I'm not really in it much. I just go from the living room on my way to the bedroom to then go into the bathroom to get ready to go out again.
So you never really spend any time here? And it's so dear. But maybe that's why you like it so much. Because if you never spend any time in it, then it keeps it special and important.
Yes. And this is the bedroom over here. Huh. You love it, I can tell. Well, don't worry, maybe I can find another place. Oh, yeah. Yes.
Darling.
Yes?
Robert.
What?
I worry.
Why?
He's all alone. There's no one.
Where?
In his life.
Oh.
Robert ought to have a woman. Poor baby, all alone. Evening after evening by the telephone. We're the only tenderness he's ever known. Poor baby.
David.
Yes?
Bobby.
What?
I worry.
Why?
It's such a waste. There's no one.
Where?
In his life.
Oh.
Bobby ought to have a woman.
Right after I became a flight attendant, a friend of mine who had a garden apartment gave me a cocoon for my bedroom. He collected things like that, insects and caterpillars and all that. He said one day I would wake up to a beautiful butterfly in my bedroom. He said that when they come out, they're soaking wet and there's a little spot of blood there too. Isn't that fascinating?
Uh-huh.
And then within an hour, they dry off and they begin to fly. Well, I told him I had a cat. Because I had a cat back then. And he said, we'll just put the cocoon where the cat can't get to it. Which is impossible. But what are you going to do? So I put it where the cat never really went, on this ledge. And the next morning, it was still there, so it seemed safe to leave it there. Anyway, maybe a week later, very, very early in the morning, this guy calls and he says, April, do you have a butterfly this morning? And I manage to get up and I look up on this ledge and there's a wet spot and a little speck of blood, but no butterfly. And I thought, oh dear God in heaven, the cat got it. And I go to pick up the phone to tell this guy, and just then suddenly I see it under the dressing table and it's moving one little wing. So the cat got it, but it wasn't dead. And I tell the guy, and he gets so upset. And he said, oh no, oh God, don't you see that's a life, a living thing? So I get dressed and I take it to the park and I put it on a rose. It was summer then. And it looked like it was gonna be all right. I think, anyway. But that man, I felt so damaged by him. Just awful. I mean, that was just cruel. And I went back home and I called him back. And I said, you know, I'm a living thing too, you shithead. And I never saw him again.
That reminds me of something I did to someone once in Miami. It's not really the same, but in a way, you'll see. I met a girl, a lovely girl, at a party one night, and it was very much like you and me, April. We just connected. You don't mind that I'm telling you this, do you?
No.
I just came into my mind. Anyway, we just connected in such a beautiful way. Exactly like tonight, except we couldn't contain ourselves. It was incredible. We were just talking, and then suddenly we just could not talk anymore. No sounds came. We stared at each other and sweat was pouring down our faces and our breath was so short and our legs were trembling and we just left. We drove to one of those strips where they have all those motels and we got inside that room and we started touching and kissing and laughing and holding. And then suddenly she said, I should go get a lot of champagne and some baby oil and we should get beautifully high. And then rub, well, you know. She said she'd be in bed waiting for me. So I rushed out of there, jumped in my car, drove around until I could find a drugstore and a liquor store that were open. I got all of the baby oil, all of the champagne, and finally I started back to her motel. And I could not find it. Three hours I looked for that motel. I never found it. And I never saw her again either.
That is the most extraordinary story I've ever heard.
I know, it is.
And that poor, poor girl.
Ooh, yeah.
And you drove around for 3 hours?
More. All night long I drove around trying to find that motel. I mean, all night. With the oil and the champagne and my hands trembling and sweat pouring down my face.
And that girl, she never knew. Well, I just don't know what to say or do. That's so sad.
I know. It is very.
Robert. Those stories don't follow. I don't see the connection. Oh. Unless you thought of that poor girl as the wounded butterfly.
Yes, that's it.
Robert, Bobby, Robert, Angel, Bobby, honey, you know no one wants you to be happy more than I do. No one, but isn't she a little bit, well,
you know,
face it,
no one wants you to be happy more than I do.
Better,
no one,
no one,
but isn't she a little bit, well, you know,
you know,
face it,
no one wants you to be happy more than I do.
You know,
no one,
no one,
but isn't she a little bit,
well, you know,
dumb,
tacky,
vulgar,
tall,
oppressive.
Where is she from?
She's old enough to be your mother.
She's
very weird, Goliath.
I got a girl for you, boy, ooh, boy.
Oh, this is sensational.
Ah, oh, I think he really likes me.
Wow, she's nice.
He's so nice. Oh, dear.
Oh, I like that.
I love that.
Such a smooth body.
What's he doing?
With all that hair, I can't even find her head.
He really likes me.
Thank you. Berlin.
Barcelona.
Oh.
Don't get up.
Do you have to?
Yes, I have to.
Oh.
Don't get up. Now you're angry.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. Put your things down.
See, you're angry.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. Put your wings down and stay.
I'm leaving.
Why?
To go to.
Stay.
I have to
fly. I know.
To Barcelona.
Look, you're a very special girl, not just overnight. No, you're a very... Not because you're bright, not just because you're bright. You're just a very special girl.
Thank you.
What you thinking?
Barcelona.
Oh.
Flight 18.
Stay a minute.
I would like to.
So.
Don't be mean.
Stay a minute. Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Where you going?
Barcelona.
So you said.
And Madrid.
Bon voyage.
On a Boeing.
Good night.
You're angry.
No.
I've got to.
Right.
Report to.
Go.
It's not to say that if I had my way. Oh, well. I guess. Okay.
What?
I'll stay.
But. Oh,
April, Shelley,
Kiki, Nancy.
Whoa, they're great kidders. This is Marta.
Oh, Marta, of course. Oh, and you were just what Robert said. So pretty and original. Oh, look, the East River.
I'm so surprised to find you guys out on your terrace.
I thought I'd fix it up.
Is our Robert not a thing of beauty and a boy forever?
How have you been, Bob?
Well, you know me. Always happy.
Bob, did Susan ever show you the terrific pictures of Mexico when I went down there for the divorce?
Divorce? You mean you two are not married now?
Well, not since the divorce.
It was so absolutely sensational. I phoned Susan to come down and join me.
We both put on 5 pounds.
So where are you living now, Peter?
Well, here at home. I still have responsibilities. I got Susan and the kids to take care of. I would never leave them.
So are you considering getting married again?
Married? Oh, no. We tried that. Thank you very much.
Oh, we're so much more married now than when we were married.
Well, I guess it takes two to make a happy divorce.
Whenever Robert's over, I get the feeling we're auditioning for him.
Well, you know my favorite quote, the unexamined life is not worth living.
Yeah, and I think mine is, the unlived life is not worth examining.
Why don't I skedaddle inside and I'll fix us a quick lunch? Oh, look, we are all four single. It's nicer, I think, especially if you have someone.
I know this is why you love New York.
Yes! Oh, come, Marta, so we can talk about you-know-who.
She's terrific, Bob. Are you excited about the younger generation?
At moments.
Oh, boy, this is when I should be being born. Bob, this is my age! Wild-ass kids with their probing minds, rebelling against all the crap. I identify with those kids.
You shouldn't. You're the enemy, just like their parents.
No, sir, not I.
Peter, we're square to those kids.
Bob, have you ever had a homosexual experience?
I beg your pardon?
I don't mean as a kid. I mean since you've been an adult. Have you ever?
Well, yeah. Yeah. Actually, I have.
You're not gay, are you?
No. No? Why are you?
No, no. Christ's sake. Have done it more than once, though.
Is that a fact?
Well, I think sometimes you meet somebody and you just kind of love the crap out of them, that's all.
Sure, absolutely. I'm sure that's true.
You just want to manifest that love,
yeah,
that's all.
I understand, sure.
I think sometimes you can even know somebody for, oh, a long, long time, and suddenly out of nowhere, you just want to have them. Even an old friend, you just all of a sudden desire that intimacy, the closeness.
Probably.
I'm convinced the two men... I'm convinced the two men really would, if it wasn't for society and all that crap. Just go off and ball. Be better off for it, too. Don't you?
Why, I don't know. That's...
Like us, for example. You think you and I could ever have anything like that?
I see what you're doing. You're putting me on. You really have me going there, you son of a gun.
They look like they're gonna hurt themselves.
What if their mothers came in and saw them up there doing that? Hmm. Think of their poor mothers.
He's embarrassing.
Anyway, people that dance and carry on and laugh like that, they're not really happy.
Think of your poor mother!
He's not what you'd call self-conscious.
He's not what you'd call. Big show-off.
It really shocks me to see a grown man dance like that. I am shocked. You hear? Shocked.
Where was I?
Oh, my first husband.
He's so difficult to remember, even when you're with him.
We got married here in New York. I was just out of college. See, he was here on some business deal, but he owned a big meat packing company in Chicago.
Attractive?
Well, we lived in New York for almost a year, and then one day he had to go back to Chicago. And you know, he was actually surprised when I told him I would just wait here for him. I mean, I still don't really quite know where Chicago is.
It's over there somewhere. He said he didn't really plan to come back, so I knew we were in a tiny dilemma. Or at least he was. I was still too young, but I was old enough to know where I was living, and I had no intention of leaving New York. I have never left New York. Never have, never will. And least of all, would I ever want to go to a place where they actually feel honored being called hog butchers of the world. They're proud of that. I said, kiss off, Rodney, but I said it nicer. Well, we got a divorce. A divorce. Huh. One word means all of that. Another drink, guy. Sir! Oh, sir!
Whew!
We already gave.
Ah, you had a few while I was dancing, huh?
Larry, what the hell was all that carrying on? What was that? Shocking.
I asked you to dance.
I only dance when you can touch. I don't think standing, bumping around, and making an ass out of oneself is a dance. I find it unbelievably humiliating watching my own husband flouncing around the dance floor, jerking and sashaying all over the place like Ann Miller. Take off the red shoes, Larry. Off.
Was I that good?
Very. Excellent. Terrifically good.
Joanne, I love it when you're jealous. Kiss me.
I hated dinner. I hated the opera. And I hate it here. What I need is more to drink. And look at Bobby, how desperately he needs another drink. Sir, two more bourbons and a vodka stinger, sir! Do you know that we are suddenly at an age where we find ourselves too young for the old people and too old for the young ones? We're nowhere. I think we better drink to us. To us. The generation gap. We are the generation gap. Are they staring at me? Let them stare. Let them, those broads. What else have they got to do? All dressed up with no place to go.
What time is it?
In real life? Will somebody get us another drink? Oh, you did. So aggressive. Stop staring! I'd like to propose a toast. Here's to the ladies who lunch, everybody laugh. Lounging in their caftans and planning a brunch on their own behalf. Off to the gym, then to a fitting, claiming their fat, and looking grim, 'cause they've been sitting, choosing a hat. Does anyone still wear a hat? I'll drink to that. Here's to the girls who stay smart, aren't they a gas? Rushing to the classes in optical art, wishing it would pass. Another long, exhausting day, another $1,000. A matinee, a pinter pay, perhaps a piece of Mahler. And one from Waller. Here's to the girls who play wise, aren't they too much? Keeping house but clutching a copy of life,
just to keep in touch. The ones who follow the rules and meet themselves at the schools, too busy to know that they're fools, or if they adjourn, I'll take an M. Let's all pray for them. And here's to the girls who just watch. Aren't they the best? When they get depressed, it's a bottle of scotch plus a little jest. Another chance to disapprove. Another brilliant singer. Another reason not to move. Another on the go, everybody tries. Look into their eyes and you'll see what they know. Everybody dies. A toast to that invincible bunch. The dinosaurs surviving the crunch. Bless their
I would like a cigarette, Larry. Remember when everyone used to smoke? How it was more festive, happier or something. Now every place is not unlike an operating room, for Christ's sake. Huh?
I never smoked.
Why?
I don't know. I meant to. Does that count?
Meant to? Meant to. Story of your life. Meant to. Jesus, you were lifted right out of a Kraft Ebbing case history. You were always outside looking in the window while everybody was inside dancing at the party. Now, I insist you smoke. Your first compromise. Here, Rob, smoke.
No, thank you.
Joanne, honey, come on, he doesn't.
You smoke. I'll watch.
Watch? Did you hear yourself? Huh? Did you hear what you just said, kiddo? Watch. I'm offering you the chance to...
I don't want one.
Because you're weak. I hate people who are weak. That's the best. Better than Librium. Smoking may be the only thing that separates us from the lower forms.
You want a split?
Of what?
See? Every day, Joanne tests me to see if I'll go away. Twice a year, my wife here packs her things to leave, so I'll ask her to stay. Well, my mother was a very difficult woman.
Who?
And my old man left her. And he regretted it until the day he died. Now me, hey, I married this wildly conceited broad with no self-esteem. My wife still has a hard time believing she found a guy she daily fascinates. And unlike my father, I'm a very happy man. She doesn't act like this when you're not around, Bobby. I hope you get to meet Joanne sometime. She's really a terrific lady. In fact, if you ever decide to get married, Bobby, make sure you find somebody just like Joanne.
Don't ever get married, Robbie. Never. Why should you?
I don't know. For company? Just like everybody else.
Who else?
Anybody who's ever fallen in love and gotten married.
I know both couples, and they're both divorced. Oh, Larry, you interrupted me before. See what happens when you rush me? I wanted to toast my second husband.
It's late. I'm going to the John, and when I come back, we will be leaving. The holiday is ending, okay?
Well, hey, I got the check. Damn it, I know he's off to pay the check. Or buy the place. It is a comfort to have rich friends, but I do like to pay for things some of the time. All right, you talk me into it. You have a good third husband, Joanne. He's a good man. Anyway, thank you for this evening. I'm glad you asked me to join you. I was feeling really low tonight, really depressed. I drank, but phew, you really put it away tonight, huh? Last several nights, you and I have gone out. I have had a shameful hangover. Abominable. We may be doing permanent damage. Ever think of that? I don't know what to think about the fact that you only drink with me. What? I mean, I guess that's not unflattering. No, I don't depress you, do I? We have good times, and it's, you know, it's a hoot, yeah? Whatever you say. No, I don't care for a cigarette, if that is what you're trying to stare me into. I'm a product of my generation, and I do not smoke. My age group is a very uptight age group. Middle age is breaking up that old gang of mine. Ooh, it is very drunk out tonight. What are you looking at, Joanne? Is it my charisma? Well, stop looking at my charisma.
When are we gonna make it?
I beg your pardon?
When are we going to make it?
What's wrong with now?
There's my place. It's free tomorrow after 2. Larry goes to his gym, then right to the office. Don't talk. Don't do your folksy Harold teen with me. You're a terribly attractive man. The kind of man most women want and never seem to get. I'll take care of you.
But who will I take care of?
Well, did you hear yourself?
Well,
did you hear what said,
kiddo? I didn't mean that.
Oh, I heard a door open that's been stuck a long time.
Like, I haven't looked at all that. At marriages and all that. And what do you get for it? What do you get?
Well, the check is paid and we... What's wrong?
I've looked into all that, into marriages and all that. And what do you get for it? What do you get?
What happened?
I just did someone a big favor. Come on, Larry. Let's us go home.
What do you get?
Bobby.
Bobby.
Bobby, baby.
Bobby, booby.
Bobby.
Robert, darling.
Bobby, we've been trying to call
Bobby,
you.
Bobby, booby.
Angel, I've got
Bravo.
Something to tell
Bobby,
you.
Bobby, honey.
Bobby, we've been trying to reach
Bobby,
you
baby.
All day.
Bobby, the kids were asking Bobby.
Bobby,
Bobby,
booby.
What have you been
Bobby, busy?
Bobby.
Stop! What do you get? Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair to ruin your sleep.
That's true, but there's more than that.
Is that all you think there is to it?
You've got so many reasons for not being with someone, but Robert, you haven't got one good reason for being alone.
Come on, you're onto something, Bobby. You're onto something.
Someone to need you too much. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short, to put you through hell.
You see what you look for, you know?
You're not a kid anymore, Robbie. I don't think you'll be a kid again, kiddo.
Don't be afraid that it won't be perfect, buddy. The only thing to be afraid of is that it won't be.
Don't stop now. Keep going.
Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, will want you to share a little, a lot.
So what does all that mean?
Robert, how can you know so much about it when you haven't been there?
It's much better living it than looking at it, Robert.
Add 'em up, Bobby, add 'em up.
Someone to crowd you with love. Someone to force you to care. Someone to make you come through, who'll always be there, as frightened as you of being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
Blow out your candles and make a wish, Robert. Want something. Want something.
Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive. Being alive. Somebody need me too much. Somebody know me too well. Somebody pull me up short and put me through hell and give me support for being alive. Make me alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Mock me with praise. Let me be bury my days, but alone is alone, not alive. Somebody crowd me with love, somebody force me to care. Somebody make me come through. I'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
Huh. Must have been the apartment across the hall.
This is crazy, huh?
Do you think something's wrong?
No, I think something's right.
So do I.
I phoned every joint in town.
It has been over 2 hours. Maybe he forgot.
Who would forget a surprise birthday?
Or maybe the surprise is on us. I think I got the message. Come on, Larry. Let's go home.
Yeah, I think we should.
Yeah, I think we should go too.
Do you think we should leave him a note?
I think we should leave him alone.
I'll call him tomorrow.
Don't.
I won't.
David.
Ron.
Nothing.
All right, everybody. All together now.
Happy birthday, Robert!